Hello everybody, Starred here and welcome back to my channel and welcome to another video. And in today's video, I just wanted to share with you guys some tips and tricks on how I finally got my skin clear. So if that's something that you're interested in, hopefully you can find something in this video that will help you out today. Definitely keep watching. So the first tip I have for you guys is to make sure that your hands are super clean before you start your facial wash or your washing process. So I absolutely love this brand. It's the Soft Soap brand, and this is in the scent Fresh Breeze. I'm almost out. That's how much I use these. Another one that I really like to use is the Dial antibacterial hand soap. I don't have that one with me right now, but I just wanted to show you guys the one that I currently use. And again, I'm pretty much almost out of this and I have to go buy another one, but definitely make sure that your hands are clean because we have so much oil and so much dirt on our hands, and you definitely don't want that transferring onto your face mid-wash. So absolutely, I made sure that my hands were clean before I started to wash my face. Before moving on to my facial wash, if I am wearing any makeup for that day, I want to make sure that all of that makeup is off of my face. So I used to use towelettes and I used to use a lot of makeup removing wipes, but I stopped using them and transitioned over to makeup removing balms. And the one that I use is the Clinique Take the Day Off Makeup Removing Balm. I really love that balm because I used to feel like whenever I was using towelettes, my skin felt so exhausted after I was doing all of that wiping and all of that tugging. It really got to me and my face felt fatigued after I used them. So I transitioned over to makeup removing balms, and it's the best thing I've ever done. So with this balm in particular that I'm talking about, it starts off as a solid balm, and then once you get it into your hands and you rub it in a little bit, it becomes this really smooth, silky oil. So between the silky oil and the pads of your fingers, it's a really soft environment for you to just really get in there and take off all of your tenacious makeup, particularly your eye makeup. I got so tired of waking up in the morning with those black smudges under my eyes because my mascara was not all the way off. And of course, you guys want to really make sure get your eye makeup off at night, especially when you're going to sleep, because you don't want anything clogging your pores and causing redness and inflammation and irritation. So that's what I did. So after I make sure all of my makeup is off, I go ahead and wash my face. So the facial cleanser that I use is the CeraVe Acne Control Cleanser. I really love this cleanser. So I know I mentioned another one in my previous videos and I use those every day, but every night, this is the one that I'm using. So what I do really love about this is not only does it help reduce your breakouts and fight the ones that are already there, it helps fight the ones that are going to pop up. And I really do like this. It helps reduce blackheads. It's oil absorbing. It has oil absorbing technology. And what I love about that particularly for me is that I have combination skin. So for anyone watching who doesn't know what combination skin is when you have neither dry skin all the way or oily skin all the way, but you have a combination of both. So for me, the majority of my face is pretty dry, but in my T-zone, which would be my forehead and my nose, I get super oily. So I really don't like that. I always had to be that person walking around with those oil absorbing sheets. I really needed to have those because at the end of the day, I totally looked like I was dumped in a bag of oil or like a pot of oil. So I was the person who had to walk around with those. So this really helps with absorbing that excess oil if you're someone with combination skin, particularly oily skin. So really like this as well. Moving on to the next step. Twice a week, I like to use a facial clay mask. And the one that I love to use is by Innisfree, and it's the Innisfree Pore Clearing Clay Mask. I really love this clay mask because it has really absorbent volcanic clusters, and I enjoy this very much. I use this twice a week. I put this on my face, I let it dry down for about 10 or 15 minutes, and I love what it does for my skin. It really helps to remove the impurities from my pores and really helps to smooth out my skin. So this is something I would use twice a week. Something that I also incorporate besides the Innisfree clay mask is this cream right here, and it's the Acne Treatment by De La Cruz. And this is the antibacterial and anti-inflammatory cream, acne cream. I really, really love this cream because it helps to soothe that irritation. So with this, if you're having like a patch of pimples, or maybe you're having a few Lone Rangers that pop up on your face every now and then, you can totally, after you've cleansed your face, you can pop this on for about 20 minutes or so. And it really does help with the redness and the swelling and the irritation. So this is something, when I'm not using the Innisfree clay mask, this is something that I would definitely use. Okay, so moving on to toner, this is something that I recently started doing in my skincare routine, particularly around the time when I was desperate to clear my skin up. And at this point, I just wanted to give a little shout out to a friend of mine, Mashi. If you're watching today's video, thank you so much for this recommendation. My friend recommended by COSRX, I think it's pronounced. It's the AHA BHA Clarifying Toner Treatment, or Treatment Toner. I really love this toner because not only is it filled with botanical ingredients that's really good for your skin, it's also going to help with that irritation and inflammation, especially if you're someone suffering with cystic acne. So what I love about this is that it's very soothing and it contains AHA, BHA. A lot of times in our skincare products, we're gonna see something called AHA in our products, and a very popular one is glycolic acid. So that's really popular in a lot of our skincare products because it really does help with that texture, smoothing the skin and removing that dead layer of skin. So you're going to be seeing a lot of things having an AHA, which stands for alpha hydroxy acid. So again, thank you for the recommendation. I really did enjoy this. As you can see, I'm almost totally out, and I buy these two at a time because I love it. Another tip, instead of using the cotton balls, because in my experience, I realized that the cotton balls were absorbing too much of the product and I was running through it a little too fast. So I decided to move over to cotton pads instead of cotton balls. So last but definitely not least, you want to put all that good moisture back into your skin. So for me, I love to follow up with this Cetaphil moisturizer. So this is their moisturizing lotion. And what I love about this is that it gives that lightweight moisture, but it doesn't have that oily, filmy texture that a lot of lotions have. So I've been using this for quite a while, and I know everyone has their own favorite moisturizer. Even for example, there's another one besides this that I love to use. It's a little expensive. It's the one by Fresh. I love that lotion so, so much. It's a bit of a splurge at $46, but I do love it. And again, if something is super expensive, if it really does work for me and I'm really seeing positive changes in my skin, I'll bite the bullet and go ahead and purchase it. For me, I love using that lotion because it makes my skin really supple and really dewy, and you have all day hydration. So basically, at the end of the day, your face doesn't feel dry and tight. And that's what I was experiencing with a lot of lotions that just were not getting the job done. So if you want a bit of a recommendation out of splurge, I do recommend the brand Fresh. So the last two things I wanted to mention super quickly would be drinking your water. I sound like a broken record. Drink your water, drink your water, drink your water. Everyone hears about drinking water, but really this really did help when I was trying to clear up my skin. I started with one bottle of water, that I worked my way up to three eventually, but I kind of got tired of having a bunch of bottles. So I definitely recommend getting like one of those big flasks that you can, you know, take around with you to work or where, whatever have you, and you'll have fresh, cool water for the entire day. Especially if you're someone that you don't have access to maybe filtered water at your job, I would highly recommend getting a flask. It'll keep your drink cool all day. And if you're someone also that just can't stomach the taste of plain water, you can go ahead and get like one of those zero calorie sweeteners that you can just freshen it up. Maybe a wedge of lemon, a wedge of strawberry, a wedge of lime, maybe some cucumbers or something to kind of spice up the flavor of your water if you're somebody that just cannot stand the taste of plain water. And lastly, I'm gonna mention drinking raspberry leaf tea. Now, I did my research on raspberry leaf tea because I'm a tea girl. I really, really love tea. But what I realized was that I was having a lot of hormonal acne. Particularly, that means you're breaking out maybe mostly around your cheeks and your chin or your jawline. And that's what was happening to me. I like to enjoy up to 2 to 3 cups a day. Sometimes I won't drink it every single day, but when I do, I can have up to 3 cups a day. You let it steep for about 15 minutes and you're good to go. So if anyone out there is looking for a nice tea that can help them with their hormonal imbalance breakouts, I do hope and recommend that you try raspberry leaf tea because it really did help me out. Well guys, that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed today's video and you got a little something out of it, which I hope you did, go ahead and leave a little love on that like button. Leave a comment in the comment section below because I would love to hear what you guys think. Feel free also to share some of your tips and tricks with me, and as always, consider subscribing to my channel because I would definitely appreciate that. So until next time you guys, I'll see you in another video. Bye!